Good luck, Kent.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. My name is Kent C Dodds. I work for a company called Alianza. It totally rocks. And this is some more information about me. This is a 5-minute talk, so you're going to get a fire hose on ng-ModelOptions. It's going to be great. So just for those who don't know, ng-ModelOptions is a directive that was introduced in Angular 1.3. You stick it on the same element as you put your ng-model on, and then you provide it an object, which we're specifying here on our view model, our controller. And then there are some configurations that you can provide. And basically, ng-ModelOptions provides you with a little bit more control on how Angular updates your model. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and look at how this works. So we just have a very simple app here. And I'm just going to really quickly show you all the features that are available for your applications. So first, update on and debounce. These are two really, really awesome features. So we say update on. And then we specify a string. So instead of the default behavior, we're going to say blur. We want it to update on blur. So if I say hello, ng-conf, and then I click away, then the model gets updated. You see the full name of the user is updated there. And if I take that away, then I click away, and it gets updated then. That's less exciting. Something that's kind of interesting about this, something you probably would never want to do, but you say if you could, you say any event in here that would make sense. So you say mouse out, or better, over, and we say hello ng-conf, and I haven't blurred yet, but if I mouse over, it updates. So any event in there will work. Don't use that. That's weird. Your users be like. But where this gets really cool is you can say default. That is not an event. That is just the default. And here, in combination with debounce, it gets really cool. So you specify a debounce object. This debounce can actually technically be an integer that will just debounce the default behavior. But we want it to debounce differently for default and blur. So we'll say default. We want it to debounce after 1 second. And blur, we'll have it debounce 0 milliseconds. And so then if I say hello ng-conf, it waits for a whole second, and then it updates. If I take that away and then blur, it updates immediately. And for those watching at home, if you didn't catch that, that's cool. So here, now we're going to go into our getter setter. What we're doing here is I'm taking the user, assigning the full name property to a function that is a getter setter function. And so what you see in here right now is like, what on earth? It's the function. Like, your users are like, what does function mean? You're like, oh, sorry, let me fix that for you. We say getter setter as true. And now it makes sense to your users, and they're like, oh, okay, text required, great. And so now we can say, hello, world. And that's not all that interesting, but what really is happening, if we look at the markup, we go down here. What we're doing is in this span where we're binding this, we're actually invoking our getter setter. So it's actually being sort of kind of bound to a function. But what really is happening is we're storing the internal value ourselves. And so you have a little bit of power there. One thing that you need to be aware of is if I say hello world, there's validation on this. And so if I backspace, I am still backspacing, but nothing's happening. And the reason for that is if I were to backspace one more, that sets the field to invalid because it has a min length of 5. And so if I deleted that, sets it to invalid, it is now undefined. And so when my getter setter is called, it's called with undefined, and nothing happens to my internal state. And so to overcome this, you say allow invalid is true. And then this all works as you would expect. You can, it's now invalid, and that's OK. The model will still get, the model will still get set to whatever you specify, regardless of validation. This is not default behavior, so you need to be careful with this, just like everything in life. OK, one last thing. Time zone. So the only option available with time zone is UTC. And here, if I specify, I change the input type to time, sorry, like to throw you out there. But if I say 1 a.m., then, and you look at the actual model value, it's saying Wednesday, December 31st at 1800. That is not what you see here. And so this provides you the ability to have the view value be specified in one time zone, and but the actual model value be specified in the browser's local time zone. So that is ng-ModelOptions in 5 minutes. If you are interested in learning, like getting a deeper dive in each of these options, I have lessons on each one of these concepts on Egghead. So feel free to explore and learn. If you're very serious about forms, then I highly recommend using Angular Formly. It is the bomb. And please ask me questions. This takes you to the Reddit questions for ng-ModelOptions and Angular Formly. So ask me questions on there. Hit me up on here or on GitHub. And thank you very much.